Okay, Mike Janthony here. I'm making this video because of some people that I know who are using SafeList to advertise their links and they're doing it wrong. So I wanted to make this video to show you how to at least attempt to make it worth your while and to do it properly. And now I'm not saying I know everything because I don't, but at least I'm not making some of the blatant newbie mistakes anymore that I see a lot of people doing. Now, as I like to advertise on safe lists, and I have up right now on screen one of the ones that I like to use that I get good results from, which is Hercules. And but the first thing you got to realize is that these are low quality traffic. They're free ways to advertise. And that's how most people use them, is they use the free options. Now, when you're advertising on these, you have to first realize what these things are. They are free and low cost, which means low quality traffic. It's going to take you more time to be able to get any results from these than if you paid for traffic. But if you're just starting out or you just don't have any money, most people start with free. And I'm one of those people, except for I've been doing this for years, and I've learned that you do have to spend a little bit of money. Like here's this one here. I'm gonna have a link to my link for Hercules underneath this video, but this particular website has 92,556 members, which seems to grow by the day because as more people come into it, the membership grows. When I first started using this one, I think I was mailing to like 40,000 people, so it's doubled that now. But if you are a free member, you can sign up for this for free, but you're only going to be advertising to 1,000 people. Okay, because that's all you can do as a free member is 1,000 people. And if you upgrade to the highest membership level, which is I believe gold, it only costs $49, so it's cheap, and you can advertise to all 92,500. So that's what I do, and that's also a lifetime membership, by the way. That is not monthly. That is $49 one time for life. So it's a good deal that I decided to do, and it's good. This is a good safe list that I like to use. I also have another video that I made that I talk about why I use some of the safe lists that I use because of their ranking in Alexa and things like that. There are some safe lists that I use that I learned I don't get any results at all. I might see some clicks, but it doesn't even pop up in my tracking. So I stopped using those, and that's one thing you got to do is you got to track. The only way you could track is by using your own website or your own tracking tools. Now, rather than going out and buying my own tracking tools, I just use my own website, my own MikeJAnthony.com site, which is right here, and let's see. Yeah, so I don't know why this thing is disappearing like that. I'm trying to figure this out. Okay. This screen should not disappear the way it's doing, but it is for some reason. And I keep having to click on it. I hope that this comes out and I don't have to remake this video. But anyway, here's my site right here. And I just make a post. I just go to all posts. It's a basic WordPress site, but I have control of it, you know? And I could just add a new post here. And see this thing. I don't know if it's even recording. I add a new post and now I have complete control. Every time I click in here, it's not. It keeps taking me off. Okay, I'm back. I had to readjust some stuff here, but yeah, so this is my site. It's a WordPress site. This is where I send people. I just create an article about something I want to promote, and then I post a link, my affiliate link, in here, because wherever your affiliate link goes in a safe list, it's most likely going to not open up. It's most likely going to get cut off, because Google and any search engine does not like affiliate links. They don't index those. They only index the top level domain, which is anything before like this right here. That like I know you can't see it, but actually, I should have Should have expanded this. But anyway, anything that has a question mark after that in your URL in the suffix, Google is going to cut that off. So I see a lot of people advertising like that, and I'm going to show you an example. And I see the mistakes that people make all the time, even when I log in, because people will buy login ads. And so these are people that are spending money, but they don't know that they're wasting their money because nobody's ever seeing them. It's the most common mistake I see constantly made all the time. And even when you log in, like this right here is somebody's login ad. You know how many times I log into this and I see like nothing there? Or such and such browser cannot open this site and you gotta click another button to be taken to the site. Those are no-nos, okay? This person's doing it correctly because it opened it right away. But I guarantee you, if I do that a couple more times, I'm going to see somebody whose link doesn't open. And that's just ridiculous because you're spending money for that. So here's another login ad that pops up. I've seen over and over again, I see nothing pop up here. And that's just crazy. It just so happened that the people who are advertising here did it right. But every day I usually see somebody that did it wrong. So I want to address that because you might be one of those people that would do that. So the first, and actually here's my affiliate link really, the raw affiliate link. I have one. What I use is redirections all the time, but Google's only going to index Hercules.com really. They're good, you know, they will index members index. All the way up to this question mark. This question mark with my affiliate ID afterwards is going to be cut off. It makes no sense to advertise this link because Google doesn't care about anything that comes after this question mark. They only care about everything before, which is not my site, which I have no control over. That's why I like to promote on my website first because I have complete control over this. Okay? So what I do when I'm when I'm creating an affiliate post for a safe list like Hercules here, and I'm going to submit. See here, these are other people's ads, and I over and over again I see either nothing pop up here or something that tells me they can't. It's blocked. The frames are blocked, and you need to click another button to go ahead to the website. No one's going to do that. Because another thing about SafeList is that people aren't there to see your business. They're there to advertise their own business. So you have to keep that in mind when you're advertising. So I'm going to get into some other mistakes that people make here in a minute, but I just wanted to show an example. Like when I go here and I post a SafeList ad, again, this is just one example, but it's pretty much universal with all the SafeLists. I like to use HTML because I'm a lifetime gold member. So I get that option. As a free member, you only get plain text. You get no option other than plain text. So another reason why I recommend upgrading. But I like to send an HTML. And here, this test, see this test URL here? They didn't always have this. They added this recently. This was actually a godsend. This was needed so that maybe I think Hercules themselves got tired of people not testing their links, putting up links that don't work. It happens constantly. And even though they have this test URL, I still see people's links that don't work that are using this. And I'm going to show you a bunch of examples soon, later on. But I'm going to show you, I think I grabbed Amazon link. Okay? One of the biggest company in the world, right? And this link will not pop up. But if I test it, it'll show me. Here it is. I'm using the Firefox browser and it just told me Firefox can't open this page. I see this constantly. Right here it says to protect your security, Amazon will not follow, well, will not allow Firefox to display the page. It says that about every browser, okay? Not just Firefox. Basically, this means that the website Amazon is using frames and they will be blocked in every single SafeList you try to use. Okay? So if you see something like this, do not use the link. Okay? And you need to test that first. I have another affiliate link, but it's going to tell you the same thing. So test the link, use this before you send. But if I put my own website in there, this is the link to my website I'm copying right now. Okay, That was Amazon. That's an affiliate. This is an affiliate Amazon affiliate link right here. See how it was blocked? But a lot of people like to take this link and they like to direct link it, it's called. They like to put this inside of the body of this SafeList email and then expect people to see it. All they're going to see is what I just showed you. Now, if I put my own link in there, and actually it's a link. Actually, I should grab this one. That's it. This is an Amazon product right here, and that's a direct link to the Amazon product. Doesn't work, right? But now if I put my link that I put an article on my own website, which is mikejanthony.com/Rolodex, and I test that, see, it pops right up. There it is, Mike J. Anthony. That's my site. And here's the Rolodex watch I was trying to send you to on Amazon. It pops right up. That means I can use this because I know since it's my site that I don't have frames that are blocking anything. This is the mistake that so many people are making when they're using SafeList advertising. They are using affiliate links and they're direct linking. They're sticking the direct link. They're not testing it. And they're putting the affiliate links down here in the body. And they're expecting that to open up and people to see it. They don't see it. No one sees that. No one's going to care to press another button to go to your website because they're not there for that. They're there to advertise their own businesses. So you got to make sure that your link opens up first and foremost before you do anything else. That means use this test button. If it doesn't have a test button, just don't direct link. Just know that you're going to have to use your own website to put your affiliate links in and then direct them to your own website. That's what you have to do. So I'm going to show you some examples of this is my email of where I send all of my SafeList email. It's kind of like a throwaway account because I know I'm going to get a ton of mails here. I get mail, as you can see, there's 12,000 in there since the last time I deleted all these. So when you're using SafeList, you have to set yourself up another separate email account just like this to accept everybody else's SafeList mails because that's what people are there for. So I just want to show you some of the mistakes that people are making. These are other people's ads that came into my throwaway Gmail account. And see, they have their links right here, but nobody really cares about these. They only care about the here, click here to get credits. Because I want to earn credits for Ad Solution Line so that I can send out my mailing, right? So I'm just going to click this one because that's the only way I'm going to get credits. See, that one's fine. Go ahead and delete. This is not one that has a credit link. But they generally look like this. That one's fine. You know, most of these are people who are doing it. You know, most of these, I'm just going to go through until I find one that doesn't work. And I could be here for a while, so. But usually I always see, because I do this a lot, so I always see somebody's link that doesn't work. Or they're using a link that would work, but it's blocked by frames. So, oh, another thing is when you're surfing, you don't want to have to scroll down. Like this one here, it's nice and short. I don't have to scroll down to get to this credit link. Other people's are so long that I have to scroll. Like here, this is good because it's short. You want to keep your ads short in a SafeList because you don't want to have to scroll. And these people are doing a good job, the ones that I'm seeing so far. You know, they're keeping their ads short and their links actually work. But you know, if you do this long enough on other SafeList, you're going to see all kinds of people. Like here's one right here. This is a no-no. This is a no-no right here. This should not be, okay? This person is doing it wrong. He's using some kind of affiliate link that doesn't open up in a browser. He should have tested this first. And he did not. So this is the mistake I'm talking about. You don't want your site to open up like this because now I have to click this blue button in order to get to their site, which I'm not going to do because I'm not there. I don't care about their website that much, right? Neither do you. So you're just going to move on, aren't you? You're never going to open something like that. So that's the example I wanted to show. There's always somebody, a lot of times where their site is not going to open because they don't test their links. So, and I want to see one where people just have like ads that are too long. For the most part, these people are doing a pretty good job, except for the one that we found that did not open. Here's one. This is too long because now I have to click page down in order to get to this credit link. That's a no-no. I don't want to have to click anything. I want to just be able to open up. See, here's another one. I got a page down now to go and get this. Don't want to have to do that. Remember, we don't care about your website. All we care about is getting the credit. So I'm just going to click here. I want to be able to just do this right away and just keep moving. So those are the, and guess what? Even though this guy had a good job with a nice short ad, his link doesn't open. So I was just about to say the two major mistakes that most people make, which is number one, their ads are too long, and number two, they use links that can't be opened up. This person is guilty of one, but not the other. He's not guilty of having an ad that's too long. This is actually a good length because I didn't have to scroll down, but his link is bad. It doesn't open up. I'm not going to sit there and click this blue link to get to his website. I don't care about his website that much. All I'm going to do is delete it and go to the next ad. And it looks like it's the same guy again. Yeah, it is same guy because here it is again. So he's posting multiple times a link that doesn't even open. You see what I mean? Here's one that's nice and short, and his link works. Now that's how it's supposed to be, okay? You don't want to do what this other guy just did. And I think that's all I wanted to tell you. So basically, that's if your ad doesn't open up like this, and this, I use Herculist to test my links because if it doesn't open in Herculist, it's not going to open anywhere. So it just means don't use that link. So whenever I'm questioning whether I should use a link or not, I go into Herculist, my Herculist account, or any account where you can test a link, and I just put test URL and I test it and I see if it will come up in frames or not. If it has a nice blocked frame, then I know that I need to write an article or something on my own website and then send them that way. Like Amazon does not come up. You can't send Amazon links there. Can't send any kind of affiliate links there. You know, they won't open up. But if I send them to my own website first with an Amazon link in it, it will open. Okay? And that's the main thing I think I wanted to say. So let me recap. In your ads, do not have links that open up like this. And also, make sure you have short enough ads where nobody has to scroll down in order to get to the credit link. Make sure you keep them short. And if you do those two things, and then of course have a headline that draws attention and curiosity is the other thing, but you're going to have to just test that. But if you just do those two things, you will knock out a lot of frustration using safe lists. Then, because if you don't, then you're just using them for no reason. You're surfing for no reason. You're wasting time for no reason. And the only other thing you have to do is you have to upgrade your account. When you're using safe lists, you must upgrade in order to get the most out of it. If you use a free account, I can guarantee you are not getting anything out of it, and you're just wasting your time. This is Mike J. Anthony, and I will see you on the next video.